Students, in this video, I will go through some exercise involving consecutive interior, alternate interior, exterior, corresponding, and vertical angle problems. Let's take a look. So, just like in the last lesson and in the last video on the exercises associated with the lesson, it is just as important for you here to be able to identify the angle relationships that's being displayed. So I'm going to go through all these different problems with you guys just to demonstrate to you, again, the importance of that and then really model for you how to practice this. So I have here 63 degrees and this unknown angle. They're on opposite sides of the transversal there. So, and they're inside of the two parallel lines. So therefore, these are alternate interior angles. And what do I know about alternate interior angles? They are the same, so that's 63 degrees. This is the same setup, essentially, right? Just oriented a little differently. This is 85 degrees, alternate interior angles. This is corresponding because here, the two angles, they're on the same side, and really, one does correspond with the other. So this is 72 degrees. Again, corresponding, even though the setup, the orientation looks a little different, okay, these are corresponding angles. This is 67 degrees. I have 61x plus 1 and 62x minus 1. Based on the orientation here, these are, once again, alternate interior angles. And what do I know about alternate interior angles? That they are going to be the same. Since they are going to be the same, I can then equate them. I can say 61x plus 1 is equal to 62x minus 1. I'm going to subtract both sides by 61x and add 1 to both sides. I end up with x is equal to 2. And since x is equal to 2 and I'm asked to solve for the angle that's bolded, this will therefore equal to 124 minus 1, or 123. These are, again, alternate interior angles, so they are 21x minus 4 will equal to 19x plus 4. Subtract both sides by 19x and add 4 to both sides. I end up with 2x is equal to 8, or x is equal to 4. Since I'm asked to solve for the angle that's bolded here, I end up with 84 minus 4, because 21 times 4 is 84, so I end up with 80. Okay. Moving on, question 7. These are consecutive interior angles, because they are on the same side, otherwise known as same side interior. So same side interior or consecutive interior, they are going to be supplementary. I know that x plus 19 plus x plus 79 will equal to 180 degrees. So therefore, combining like terms, 2x plus 119 plus 79, what will that be? That will be 198 is equal to 180. Subtract both sides by 198, I end up with 2x is equal to negative 18. Divide by 2, x is equal to negative 9. Since x is equal to negative 9, I can then directly substitute what x is back in. I end up with x plus 79 will equal to 70 degrees. Moving on, question number 8. These are, once again, consecutive interior angles. And what do I know about consecutive interior angles? They are going to be supplementary. So I say 25x plus 20x will equal to 180. Combine like terms, 45x is equal to 180. Divide by 45, x will equal to 4. And if x is equal to 4, 25x is going to be 100. So don't let the extra line fool you, okay? We have lines that are parallel. So because they're parallel, we can then say that these are alternate interior angles, and we know alternate interior angles are congruent. So we say 7x plus 3 is equal to 6x plus 14. Combine like terms, subtract 6x, subtract 3, I end up with x is equal to 11. And since x is equal to 11, we then end up with 3 times 7 is 21, plus 3 is 24. Question 10. Don't let this other stuff here fool you or confuse you. So these angles here, they're on the same side of the transversal. Because they're on the same side of the transversal, they are going to be supplementary. So we say 128 plus x plus 68 plus x, that will equal to 180 because they are supplementary. All we got to do is just combine like terms. We got 2x plus 196 is equal to 180. Subtract both sides by 196. We get 2x is equal to 16. Divide by 2, x is equal to 8. Since x is equal to 8, 128 plus 8, that will be 136. I have a transversal. These are on opposite sides of the transversal, and they're outside of the parallel lines. So therefore, this is going to be alternate exterior angles. And we know alternate exterior angles happen to be the same. So 24x is equal to 23x plus 5. Subtract both sides by 23x, we end up with x is equal to 5. Since x is equal to 5, I know that this will equal to 115 plus 5 is 120. Moving on. I have 9x plus 9 and negative 9 plus 11x. They are alternate exterior angle. They're on opposite sides of the transversal. Alternate exterior angles are congruent, so therefore we can say 9x plus 9 is equal to negative 9 plus 11x. Combine like terms. Subtract by 11x from both sides, I get negative 2x. Subtract 9 from both sides, I get negative 18. Divide by negative 2, x equals to 9. Since x is equal to 9, negative 9 plus 11 times 9, so that's 99 minus 9, or it's 90. Question 13. Same side interior, consecutive interior, are supplementary. Add them together. We get 2x plus 194 is equal to 180. Subtract both sides by 194. Divide by 2. Since x is equal to 7, this is 119. Question 14. Same side interior are supplementary. X plus 96. Since I have two of them, I'm just going to multiply this by 2. This is equal to 180. This is the same thing as x plus 96 is equal to 90. Subtract both sides by 96. X is equal to negative 6. Since x is equal to negative 6, these are going to be 90 apiece. But we already knew that walking in because the goal was to figure out what x plus 96 was equal to, right? Anyway, so 19x minus 3 and 18x plus 4, same side, right? They're on the same side. They are corresponding. So 19x minus 3 is equal to 18x plus 4. Subtract both sides by 18x and add 3. I end up with x is equal to 7. Since x is equal to 7, then therefore this is equal to 18 times 7. What is that? That is equal to 126. No, I take that back. 18 times 7, 116. 116 plus 4 is 120. That will be 120. Let me double check that. 126. Plus 4 is 130. This should be 130. Okay. Two angles, same side, inside of the parallel lines. Consecutive interior angles are supplementary. 34x minus 1 is equal to 11x plus 1. Subtract 11x from both sides, add 1 to both sides. They're not equal. They're supplementary. I've got a little ahead of myself. They equal to 180. So combine like to erms. I end up with 45x is equal to 180, or x is equal to 4. Since x is equal to 4, this will be 45. 11 times 4 plus 1 is 45. Question 17. Consecutive interior angles yet again. So I will do 15x minus 5 plus 4x plus 14 is equal to 180. Combine like terms. 19x plus 9 is equal to 180. Subtract both sides by 9. 19x is equal to 171. Divide both sides by 19. What will that turn out to be? I don't know what that is. So 171 divided by 19 is 9. How did I not get that? Okay, so x is equal to 9. So I end up with 9 times 15 minus 5. So that's 135, 130. Okay. And moving on. Consecutive interior angle yet again. So I have x plus 64 plus 134 plus x is equal to 180. Combine like terms, 2x plus 198 is equal to 180. Subtract both sides by 198, 2x is equal to 18. Divide by 2, x is equal to 9. Since x is equal to 9, I end up with 73. And is that it? I believe that is it.